Hey guys, this is Divya here, the founder of Veda Earth, and today we are going to be discussing the live session is all about hair care. And in hair care, we are especially talking about frizzy hair. I know monsoon is here, and you know, with monsoon, everyone loves the cold weather and you know, the cooler temperatures. But along with it, there are some things that affect our hair and skin differently because of the changing weather. So due to monsoon, because of higher humidity in the air, our hair tends to get a lot more frizzier. You can check out my hair. My hair is frizzy all the time, regardless of the weather. It's just genetically I have curly hair, so it tends to stand and I tend to have a lot of flyaways all the time. It is difficult to maintain, or it's difficult to get them to stay flat. So, but I'm not too bothered about it. I like my natural hair the way it is. So let's get to it. Let's talk about frizzy hair and how can we control it. Frizzy hair, you know, your hair texture predominantly is because of your genetic. So there are three types of hairs. There's straight, curly and wavy. Of course, when you get into it a lot more professionally, they are categorized by different types of hair in the salon industry. But here, for simpler understanding, I'm just going to talk about straight hair, curly and wavy hair. Now, frizz can happen to any hair type. Frizziness is nothing but when the hair loses its moisture, it tends to stand and it doesn't tend to lay flat. So that's when you think that it is out of place and it's difficult to get it to stay in place. So because genetics plays an important part on how your hair texture is, what is controllable by us is of course eating right. It's important that we eat healthy, and the kind of foods that we eat should be rich in protein. Ensure you eat a lot of proteins, because our hair is made up of keratin and that is mostly made up of protein. So it's important that if we take a good enough protein, our hair is strong. And then of course we need to eat foods that are rich in omega-3 fatty acids and iron, so that the hair is strong from the root till the tip. Some of the good alternatives or foods which are good for keeping your hair long and strong are stuff like walnuts, spinach. These are some of the things that you can include in your diet. Let's start, you know, one by one. Today's session is going to be half an hour to 45 minutes. So I'm going to take you through quickly some of the points that we need to look into. So one thing that we need to look into to maintain good hair health is of course combing the hair well every single day, so that whatever oil that our scalp produces gets distributed to the length of the hair as well. And combing hair not only improves the circulation in the scalp, but it ensures that your hair is healthy and well aerated. So, you know, when we talk about combs, we need to be careful. A lot of us tend to use combs which are made of plastic, and so plastic tends to increase the static in your hair. So that's when it tends to make it lift a lot more. So one of the combs that I personally use is, I tend to use wooden combs or natural combs, because these will keep down the static in your hair, which in turn will reduce the frizziness that is shown. So you can use wooden combs like these. So you will not find this kind of comb here, because this I picked it up on my travel to Africa. So you can find such kind of combs. You will get closer tooth combs and wide tooth combs. It's important first to comb your hair with a wider tooth comb to remove any kind of tangles, and then move on to the closer tooth comb to make your hair sit in place. This wider tooth comb will ensure that all the tangles get removed, and then you don't lose out your hair. Most of the time when we use a closer tooth comb, it tends to get caught up in your hair, and then when you try to pull it away, it actually, you know, pulls your hair and you tend to lose a lot more hair because of it. So it's important to do that. And also another thing, another tip when it comes to maintaining good hair health, especially for frizzy hair, is to ensure you oil your hair very well. I know some of you, you know, are used to this concept of oiling. Maybe you do it once or twice in a week. Some of you keep away from oils because you feel you have oily hair or oily scalp. Let me not use it. But why do you need to oil your hair? Your scalp is nothing but an extension of your skin. Your scalp needs to be well hydrated for it to be nourished and to ensure that your hair is healthy. Massaging your scalp with oil ensures that it keeps it healthy. The problem with hair oils that most people do is they tend to apply it to the rest of the length of the hair. But your hair is nothing but dead tissue. It does not, maximum the oil will get absorbed and keep your hair soft. But if you want to improve hair growth, it is important that you apply the oil to your scalp. Whatever you apply to your hair will not promote hair growth. So it's important, look at scalp health and apply whatever oil you're using. I'm going to be, so I apply hair oil almost every day. Since lockdown started, I apply it every day. Now you'll be wondering, how can I apply hair oil every single day to my scalp? You know, it will probably, my hair will look very oily or very greasy. Well, there's a technique to applying hair oil. I won't be showing you how to apply this hair oil on my own hair. I'm going to have three of my family members come in here and I'm going to be demonstrating to you how it works and how simple this is, and each one of you will be able to do this at home. So I'm going to have Sahitya come in right now. I'm going to show it on his hair. Sahitya has straight hair, almost straight hair. So I'm going to show you how oil is applied very quickly with some small tips. Hi Sahitya.
Hi Divya.
Please sit down.
Hi guys.
So guys, you all need to know, we need to maintain social distancing. Here I cannot because I'm showing you in a video. But please mask on. Okay, it's really important that you stay safe. Put on your mask. So to encourage that, we do that at Vedar. So I'm having him wear a mask here. So as I was mentioning, we have our Vedarth hair oil. We use it for anti-hair fall. Now people may be wondering that, or you may have presumed that Veda Earth is probably a women's brand. Let me just correct you. Veda Earth is a unisex brand. Veda Earth is for anyone and everyone. So Veda Earth products can be used by men too. Here's the anti-hair fall oil. I'll just demonstrate how I use the hair oil on my hair, showing it on Saithya's hair. You can do this every single day to ensure that your scalp is well nourished and healthy and your hair grows stronger. When your hair is healthy, the frizziness also tends to come down. So what I do is, because we already have this flip top cap, it's very easy for application. So it's important, I'm just going to take a comb here to kind of part his hair. As I mentioned, it's important that the hair oil be applied to the scalp. What you apply to the rest of the hair will only keep it softened, but really does not help. Saitya, can you hold this for me? Yeah. So what I do is, I usually take the bottle, it's very simple, and then quickly, while pressing it very lightly, move it across the scalp. It's important to do this so that the oil goes to the scalp and lesser to the hair. That's where you require the nutrition, right? You want to apply it even towards the back of your scalp, because your hair oil needs to be spread out very well. and towards the front as well. Now this oil, that's it. So if you see, I applied 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, once behind 6 and once in the front, and then quickly spread it across on your hair. Saithya here is growing out his hair. I'm sure a lot of the guys, to maintain during lockdown, you cannot go down to your barber, are growing out your hair and beard and all of that. So our hair oil is really good at keeping your hair well nourished. So you want to quickly just spread the oil. And one tip here is, when you're applying hair oil, you need to ensure that you move your scalp. A lot of the time we tend to do this motion, but we move only the hair. But you need to literally press your scalp and move the scalp. So here, as you see, I am not moving my finger, but I'm just moving his scalp around. This ensures that the circulation in his hair increases. The scalp is the most important part. If you want to have good hair, ensure your scalp is well nourished. And our Vedarth anti-hair fall hair oil is not only good for controlling hair fall, but it also promotes good hair health as well. So once the hair fall is controlled, then it promotes new hair growth as well. So once this quick massage has happened of the hair oil, you can do this. It's not even going to take 5 minutes to do this at your house. I'm just demonstrating this. Once it's done, another tip, guys, hold your hair and just give it a light tug. What this does is, you're again stimulating your scalp. You just want to give a very light pull at your hair, not too much, all around. This ensures that whatever hair is weak, those are the ones that will fall out. So you need not worry that initially when I started this out, oh my God, my hair is falling out badly. What is falling off is actually your weaker hair. And you, over a period of 1 week or few days, your hair will get used to it, and you won't find that much of hair fall, right? So now, can I have the comb? Yeah. So if you see, quickly you can just comb your hair whatever style you want to. You can comb it, you can comb your hair however you want to. As you can see, he has straight hair. The hair doesn't look too oily. If you want to style your hair as well, hair oil is a very good natural product to look at to help you style your hair and let it stay in place. And that's it. If you are uncomfortable having this hair oil in your hair, you can wash your hair after 2 hours. So why I recommend that you leave it on for 2 hours is that you want to ensure that the essential oils present in this hair oil gets absorbed into your hair. So leave it on for 2 hours and then wash your hair. That's it for the oiling section of the part. So thank you, Saithya, for helping me out for today. Yes. Now, since we came back to the section of, once you've applied the oil, it's also important to ensure that how you wash your hair, right? So when you wash your hair, always ensure to use sulfate-free shampoos. Why? Because sulfate is a very strong detergent used in commonly in a lot of the hair care products. When I call it detergent, it's a very high foaming product. With high foam, what it does is it also dries out your scalp. If you already have dandruff, if you already have a dry scalp or even an oily scalp, sulfate products which have sulfates in it, commonly known as SLS or SLES, these tend to irritate your scalp a lot more and leave it very damaged. So it's not good for your hair in the long run. So always switch to a sulfate-free shampoo or sulfate-free conditioner or hair care products itself. These, when it dries out your hair, the frizz tends to stand out a lot more in your hair. So try to stay away from sulfate free shampoos. So let me quickly just show you. At Vedarth, we have sulfate free shampoos for all three types of hair. Moisturizing shampoo with coconut milk and chamomile for people who have a dry hair. We have the anti dandruff shampoo with basil and tea tree, which is good for dandruff. And we do have the refreshing shampoo for people who have oily scalp or oily hair, which helps you give lot more volume to your hair. This has rosemary and peppermint. So you can check out any of the three shampoos at Veda Earth. All are sulfate free, free of SLS and SLES. You can try these out. These can be again used by both men and women. So that comes to hair washing. One of the other things what we do when we wash our hair is, you know, a lot of us are used to towel drying our hair, and sometimes when we use towels, you know, the Indian way of doing it, I know it's way we have learnt it from our parents and all of that, we tend to tie up our hair with a towel and then keep it tied up, right, till for a few minutes till we get ready. And some of the times we tend to leave it on and then continue doing our work. What this happens is, if you have tied up your hair very tightly, it tends to put your hair in a lot of tension. Your hair is already wet and weak. When you tend to have it tied up very tightly, it damages your hair. So try to keep it little bit loose. Don't tie it too tightly. The next thing what we tend to do when drying our hair, example is, if I have my hair, imagine my hair is long and I have it tied up, you'll tend to do this with your hair, you know, rubbing your hair to try to get it to dry. This is very bad for your hair, and this increases the frizz in your hair already, because you're increasing the static by rubbing your hair and increasing the friction amongst your hair. Now this may remove the moisture from the hair and make it dry, but this will tend to cause a lot of breakage, and this also increases split ends. So it's important not to rub our hair this way and do it. It's damaging to the hair. Try to dab it. So if you have your hair tied up in a knot, or however you tend to do after a hair wash, try to dab it and squeeze out all the water, and then remove the towel. And then I personally like to air dry my hair, which means I do not like to use a hair dryer, because I already have frizzy hair and it's very dry. Whenever I use a hair dryer, it tends to make it a lot more frizzier, and hair dryer in the long run damages your hair. So it's not good to use hair dryers every time you take a hair wash. Some of you wash your hair every single day, some of you use it twice a week, thrice a week. So imagine, heat damages your hair. It opens your hair cuticle and increases the damage. So it's not good to use a hair dryer. Try to reduce the usage of hair dryer. If you cannot, then at least once in a week try to air dry your hair. Leave it to naturally dry out. If you have thicker hair, it may take more than 1 hour or 2 hours. But since it's lockdown, all of us are anyway at home, give your hair a break. Give it to naturally air dry. So that is another tip for you guys, to ensure that your frizz is in control, how you dry your hair. So along with monsoon weather, what comes is we tend to have a lot of hair fall. So this is commonly seen because of the change in weather or the change in water condition. These also tend to cause a lot of hair fall. So it's good to use the anti-hair fall hair oil, or you can use the sulfate free shampoos. All of the tips I mentioned earlier is good for good healthy hair anytime, not just for frizzy hair, any hair, right? And let's talk about frizzy hair quick hair tip. This is something I like to do. What I do is, I take the hair mist what we have, which is the rose water or the lavender water. This is a This is a tip that not many of you will know. But did you know you can use rose water or lavender water for your hair as well? So what I like to do is I take few sprays of this in my hand and then rub it quickly and then just use it to have my hair lay flat. I'd like to do this whenever I'm stepping out, because this is a very nice tip. So this ensures that my hair, if you see, compared to starting of the video, my hair tends to be a lot drier, and because this is a water-based product, it will dry up within few minutes and it will not give you an oily look. This is good for styling your hair and this is also good for keeping your hair flat. This also has a very nice smell, aroma, because this is natural lavender water or lavender hydrosol and rose water or rose hydrosol, whichever is your choice. You can have this and spray it onto your hair either directly or put it on your hand and then tap it onto your hair and you'll be smelling good, your hair. It's like a natural hair perfume. Another tip, quick tip, you can apply the rose water to your scalp. If you have very dry, itchy scalp, you can apply the rose water to your scalp and then just massage it lightly and leave it on. You don't need to wash your hair because this is a water-based product. This is a good tip. Lavender water, again, if you have lot of itchiness or oily scalp, you can use even the lavender water, or a dry hair, you can use this for scalp. This is something that most of us would not know. We usually tend to use it only on our face, but you can use it on your hair as well. Now let's come to the DIY part of the section. So I showed you on Sahitya, who has straight hair. Now I'm going to have another family member of mine come in here, and this is my sister Deeksha. She has wavy hair. So that's Deeksha. She's already ready and waiting. So we are going to come to the hair mask section of the hair. So I'm going to have Deeksha come in and sit down here. Yes. So Deeksha here has wavy hair. I have curly hair just like my mom. Deeksha has wavy hair. She doesn't have too many curls. So I'm going to have you demonstrate. We're going to make a hair mask to be used, which is good for controlling frizz. But first, let me start by asking Deeksha what is her hair concern, so that we can customize the hair mask for whatever concern she has. So Deeksha, what is your hair concern?
I usually have a very oily scalp and I also have dandruff sometimes, itchy scalp.
Okay.
So yeah.
So Deeksha's hair tends to get oily, but she also has dandruff. So one of the things, of course, that I would recommend is to use anti-dandruff shampoo if you have dandruff, which is good for those who have itchy scalp. Now, apart from that, we are going to make a customized hair mask for Deeksha. These are DIY masks. You can make these at home as well. So I'm going to have Deeksha just hold the bowl here for me. One of the ingredients we're going to use is banana. Banana is very good for the hair because of its high potassium content. It will give you very glossy, shiny hair. But did you know banana is also good for dandruff? If you did not know, you can know that banana is good for dandruff. And because we're going to be doing it on Deeksha's hair, we're going to have banana here. So I'm going to quickly take one banana. Banana is a very good alternative wherever you want to use, even for strengthening the hair, if you did not know, because banana is also, just like its texture, which is soft, it will make your hair also soft. And if you have observed any of the vegan baking recipes, banana is also an alternative to egg. So wherever you use egg even for a protein treatment. So I'm gonna have just Deeksha mash up one banana here. I think we're probably gonna, no, we'll have just one banana should be enough. So I'm gonna have her mash up the banana. So banana is good for people who have oily scalp and dandruff. Banana will moisturize your hair while not increasing the oiliness which is already present. So along with banana here, we are also going to be adding castor oil. We're going to take little bit of castor oil, about 1 spoon of castor oil that is mixed in. Now the reason why we are using freshly mashed up bananas is because if you have banana mashed up beforehand and if you keep it, it tends to turn brown. So you want to use, and guys, don't worry, if you have banana that has over ripened, you can still use it for your hair. Only thing is, an over ripened banana will have lot more sugar content in it. So it's always good to use something that is medium ripened, not overly ripened, nor very unripe as well, because then you won't be able to mash it well. You want it to be completely mashed up, and it's good to mash it up with a fork. So apart from this, just banana and castor oil is not enough for your hair. What we need to do is, specifically because Deeksha mentioned she has dandruff, we are going to use an essential oil in this to help combat dandruff, which is tea tree essential oil. Now what we want to do is, we want to add few drops of essential oils. Essential oil products are very concentrated, so always essential oils is added in form of drops. So what we do here is, we are going to add 5 drops of tea tree essential oil. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You probably wouldn't be able to see this here, but I've added it and I can already smell the tea tree oil. Tea tree is a very good antifungal property it has. So it's very good at calming down your irritated scalp and reduce the dandruff. So we have taken banana here. Because I am doing this in a short period of time, I am going to quickly apply it on Deeksha's hair. But when you do it at home, take your time, do it slowly, and ensure you apply it properly to your hair. Now, because it's a frizzy hair treatment, here I have taken only one banana. But you can actually take up to 2. Actually, we'll just quickly add another also, because it seems to be very less. So take up to 2 bananas. We have taken the smaller variety of banana here. If you're taking the larger one, you can have this thing. You can have just add 1. So I see Sunita here saying, wear mask and gloves. Yes, Sunita. So since if I wear the mask right now, you probably will not be able to hear me that well, because my voice will be muffled. So for safety, we have had Deeksha wear the mask here. But if you are in Bangalore, you can definitely visit our Veda Earth Lounge Spa. We have taken extra safety where everyone is wearing the complete PPE kit with the shield to ensure whenever the service is being given, extra safety is taken care. Because this is, we are family and this is being done at home, you need not worry. But of course, when you go out, always wear a mask. So I'm going to quickly use my hands to apply this hair mask onto Deeksha's hair. You want to kind of, so if you see, it's very sticky in consistency, but this is required because you don't want it to kind of fall off in from your hair. So quickly you want to just move it across the hair while parting it. Now the banana mask will tend to leave pieces across your hair. So ensure you wash it away properly. This banana mask needs to be only left into your hair for maximum of 20 to 30 minutes. You don't require too long. Ensure you apply it to the scalp as well, because the tea tree oil should get absorbed into the scalp. I'm doing this quickly because I'm going to have one more DIY session after Deeksha to show you how, what kind of mask is required if you have curly hair. Deeksha has wavy hair here, so I'm using the banana, castor oil and tea tree, which is good for dandruff. If you do not have dandruff, you can use oils like lavender or even rosemary. Rosemary is very good for those looking for controlling their hair fall. So you can add in whatever essential oil you want to, so that it takes care of your hair concern. You want to ensure you coat every single strand of the hair, and especially closer to the scalp. And if you are not used to applying hair masks to your own hair, have one of your relatives or family member apply this, so that every single hair is coated properly. Also, ensure you have a towel put across so that you don't have any of this fall onto your clothing, and it's easier to wash off the towel later on as well. So we have applied the banana mask. Deeksha's hair was short. It reached only up to her shoulder. So it required two small bananas to be used for that much length. You'll have to take the amount of, you'll have to see for the length of your hair, you may require a lot more. Or use a bigger, different variety of banana to ensure it gets. Banana mask is good for hair gloss treatments, where you require your hair to be smooth and shiny, control the frizz while not promoting oily scalp. Tea tree will control the dandruff and itchiness. And did you know castor oil is also good for dandruff because it has anti-inflammatory property. So it will help you even control dandruff as well, and because castor oil is here, it also helps in hair growth as well. Now I would suggest we added castor oil here because I did not apply hair oil first, but whenever you do a mask treatment for your hair, always apply hair oil to your scalp and then do the mask. Usually these masks are for your hair and does not concentrate on the scalp. What you want to ensure is both your scalp gets the treatment as well as your hair, so that overall your hair stays frizz free. So I would suggest you to use the Vedarth anti hair fall hair oil on your scalp and then apply the mask. So this mask will quickly start to dry. I have almost, you can just show, we have quickly applied the hair mask to Deeksha's hair. And before applying hair mask, ensure you have removed all tangles. Deeksha here had come pre-prepared. Remove all tangles from your hair, so that, because this mask tends to harden up, and when you try to wash it off, if there's already tangles in your hair, then your hair will tend to have a lot of hair fall when you try to wash it, or when you try to remove all these pieces of banana. Ensure you wash it off very well. Yeah. So thank you, Deeksha, for being our volunteer here for the banana hair mask. Now I'm going to have another person walk in, another family member walk in. So So right now Deeksha's was wavy hair. Next we are going to have one more family member of mine come in here. That's going to be my mom Asha. She has curly hair. So let's look at how can we control curly hair. Curly hair tends to have lot of natural frizz because of the hair texture. So it's very difficult to maintain curly hair. It tends to get tangled very quickly, have lot of knots as well. So it's difficult to comb through hair. So one of my earlier tips I mentioned, always use a wide tooth comb first to remove any tangles and then use your normal brush, and try to use natural brushes made of natural wood or natural fibers. This will ensure that the static in your hair does not increase. Plastic bristles or plastic combs tend to increase the static in your hair, and this tends to increase the frizziness as well. So always look at that. So I'm going to quickly wipe my hand, and now I'm going to have my mom step in here so I can show you another hair mask recipe on her hair. So I'm going to have my mom Asha, who is also the co-founder of Veda Earth and Veda Earth Lounge. This is my mom. Hi guys. So as you can see, my mom has naturally curly hair. I get my curly hair from her. And that is what sets us apart. Many people say that I look like a younger version of my mom because of the hair. So here, she has already pre-combed her hair to remove the tangles. If I were to remove the amount of tangles in front of you here on camera, it will take me more than 20 minutes to just remove the tangles. So quickly I'll have her remove her hairband. So this will show you she has naturally curly hair. As you can see, curly hair tends to stand out, stand up. It's difficult to maintain curly hair. My mom has decided to let go of hair coloring because she feels that she wants to embrace her natural hair color. So she really does not mind the gray hair. So I'm not doing any kind of, I'm not showing you anything for graying hair here. So we're going to talk about how to maintain frizzy hair, especially if you have curly hair type. So I'm going to ask her quickly, what is your hair concern, so that we can make a hair pack especially for her.
It tangles a lot, okay, after I wash, and I also have some hair fall.
So her main concerns are hair tends to tangle a lot, so it requires lot more moisturization, and also her hair has hair fall. So firstly, I would recommend that use hair fall oil. She already uses hair fall oil every single day. So both of us use the hair oil every single day, and on our curly hair, you really won't even notice that the hair oil is there. If you missed out on the section, once the video ends, you can check out the video where I've shown you how to use hair oil every single day without actually getting the oily feeling and promoting hair growth. And since it's lockdown, give your hair a break, nourish your hair, cherish it, and ensure it grows well. So here what we are going to do is, one of the ingredients we are going to use here is the good old coconut. Lot of us know that coconut oil is good for hair growth, and many hair oils anyway have coconut oil in it. But one of the ingredients that is used lesser is coconut milk. Coconut milk is produced from the white flesh of the coconut, and mix it's basically grinded paste of coconut along with water. You grind it into a fine paste until it's of a milky consistency. Coconut milk is a very good a natural protein treatment for the hair, vegan protein treatment for the hair. At Veda Earth, all our products are vegan, so even the DIY section of the video also, I'm giving you vegan recipes because we believe that there are a lot of plant alternatives that you can use for your hair than use animal based ingredients or animal byproducts. So coconut milk is what we're going to take. Now, since we're short of time, I purchased coconut milk from the store. I'm sure each of you can do it, or if you have availability of fresh coconuts, you can prepare it at home. So I'm going to take coconut milk for her hair here. It's quite liquidy. So we're going to have the coconut milk, and because she told that she has hair fall, I'm just going to clear away this station so that I can keep it. Because she told that she has a lot of hair fall, I'm going to use rosemary essential oil. Rosemary is also an ingredient which already we use in our anti-hair fall oil. This already controls naturally it controls hair fall and promotes good hair growth as well. So rosemary and coriander is what we use, coriander seed in our hair oil. We also have the rosemary essential oil. Rosemary is good for hair fall. So we are customizing her coconut milk. We are going to add few drops of rosemary essential oil in it. We are going to add 5 drops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 drops of rosemary essential oil to coconut milk. Coconut milk is also high in very medium chain fatty acids. So it's already rich in fat. So you don't need to mix in an oil right here. But however, if you want to nourish your scalp, I would recommend you to apply hair oil to your scalp alone first, and then continue to put this mask onto the rest of the length of your hair. Coconut oil is high in lauric acid. So it has a natural capability of getting absorbed into the cuticle of your hair and also moisturize it. So it's an ultra moisturizing hair mask, coconut oil. So it's really good for people who have frizzy hair. Lot of our Veda Earth products, if you see our moisturizing shampoo and moisturizing conditioner is good, has coconut milk as one of the primary ingredients in it, because coconut milk extract, what we use in our Veda products, is good for damaged, dry damaged hair. With the dry hair, the damage tends to be a lot higher because it tends to break off very easily, and also it doesn't get nourishment as much, meaning when you comb your hair, the oils from your scalp doesn't tend to reach till the tip of your hair, which is why most of the time people who have curly hair tends to have lot drier hair, but their scalp need not necessarily be dry. So here, if you see, it's quite liquidy. So I'm just going to quickly start from the top of her hair and just start applying. Because it's liquidy consistency, it will spread lot easily. So I'm going to just quickly, we're going to have some spill moments here, guys. So have a towel handy. And because if you are at home, you can kind of do this without having to worry. And anyway, you are going to wash your hair, so don't worry about the spills. Have a towel put in so that you don't have to worry about this. So mom, can I have you hold the bowl? So we have mixed in the coconut milk with rosemary oil. 5 drops of rosemary oil is enough. She had already applied hair oil this morning to her scalp. So I'm not applying it again. I'm just applying directly the mask to her hair. It's important to ensure that the hair is completely drenched in coconut milk here, so that the coconut milk gets absorbed very well into the hair. Coconut milk also strengthens the natural keratin in your hair, especially good for damaged hair. When your hair is stronger, it will tend to have lesser breakage. So while wiping it away, I had her bindi come off. I'm just gonna stick it in quickly. So we're going to apply the coconut milk mask. So guys, you can do this for your family members. Guys and girls, when I say guys, doesn't mean that I'm addressing just guys here. So you can do this for your family members. It's a good way to bond along with them. And while also taking care of each other, it's important that we take care of each other. Sometimes our moms tend to get very busy and, you know, they'll take care of us very well, but tend to take, tend to forget to take care of themselves. So we can do something like this for them and ensure that they have a relaxing time. You can apply rosemary essential oil if you have hair fall. You can apply lavender essential oil if you want relaxation. If you're just looking at relaxation and for just itchy scalp with no dandruff, you can apply lavender essential oil. Check out the essential oils is available for purchase on Veda Earth website, and we are also available on Amazon and Flipkart. So you can of course purchase these products from there. We are also there on Qtrove and Nykaa as well. So wherever you find, you can look at that. However, I would recommend you to purchase directly from the Veda Earth website, because purchase from the Veda Earth website ensures you get extra goodies along with your purchase, and extra exclusive discounts on rituals. So at Veda Earth, we believe that for proper skin or hair care routine, it's important to use complementary products. It's not one product that will ensure that you have healthy hair. It's from the hair oil that you use to the hair shampoo, ensuring you use sulfate-free, silicone-free products for shampoos and conditioners, and to essential oils, whatever you use for your hair, it's an all-round treatment that your hair requires. Just using a single product will not help in giving you good hair. And any kind of treatment that you use for your, any kind of hair treatment that you start off, it's going to take at least 21 days for your skin or hair to get adjusted to this new product. So if you decide that a hair care or skincare product doesn't work before that, you are doing a mistake. We have to wait 21 days. And also when it comes to hair care products, you need to wait a lot longer, because your hair naturally tends to grow 1 centimeter. I'm talking about normal hair growth, on average 1 centimeter every month. So even if you're using any product for hair growth or anything for nourishing your hair, it will take quite a while for you to notice the difference. Since hair is dead tissue, new hair growth that you'll observe near your scalp will tell you whether the product is actually working or not. So have patience. It takes at least 2 to 3 months for you to be able to tell whenever if a hair care product is working well for you. And especially when you shift from harsher chemicals like SLS or SLES based shampoos or hair care conditioners with it. When you shift first time to sulfate free shampoos or silicone free shampoos and conditioners, you may notice hair fall. It's totally normal to notice this the first time. Because when your hair is getting adjusted to the it was used to this harsh chemical product so far, so it will take a while for it to get adjusted to the new formula, and then it starts working for you. So do not give up on your hair care products within a week. So as you can see, I had applied almost, so I'm going to quickly just take in. So I've applied it to the length of her hair. I concentrated on the scalp a lot more because we want to ensure that her scalp is well hydrated, because the scalp is where the coconut milk is required to ensure that her hair grows softer. The new hair grows softer and the frizz is controlled. So you want your complete hair drenched in this. You can notice her hair has absorbed a lot of it, because drier hair tends to absorb a lot more product very quickly, especially any such product. So you may require a lot more, versus if you have, say, the coconut milk based mask that I showed you, you can use even on oily hair. If you did not know, coconut is also has anti-inflammatory properties. So it's also good for people who have oily scalp or who have dandruff. So you can use, you can also make a super mask. Take the first mask recipe what I showed you. A super mask is basically combining both the masks and getting complete benefits for your hair and scalp. So what you can do is add banana for the mask, add castor oil, also you can add the coconut milk, and then customize the essential oil based on your concern. Add 5 drops of the essential oil, mix this banana coconut mask and apply it. This will not only leave your hair very voluminous and shiny, but it will moisturize it very well. You can use coconut milk based products even if you have oily scalp, oily hair or dandruff prone hair. So I have some people, which is your favorite shampoo? I have personally have very dry hair because it's curly. So I tend to use the Vedat moisturizing shampoo, which is sulfate free and silicone free. I like to use this. This has coconut milk, the same one which I use. But what people assume is that DIY recipes is good enough to be used. I don't need to use some of the products available in the market. But why it will not work too much in the long run, just relying on DIY products, is the concentration. These products have been formulated professionally by experts. What it means is, when I say this product contains coconut milk, it contains the extract of coconut milk. So here we use coconut milk extract. I don't know if you can see, it's kind of blurring out, so I'm not able to show you well. But yeah, coconut milk extract. And coconut milk extract is lot concentrated. So we tend to use something that is 1:5 concentration, which means that if you take 100 ml of coconut milk, and if you take coconut milk powder, so you may actually add very less of the coconut milk extract because it is that much potent and concentrated. So these products will have the same benefits of whatever natural ingredient you will use in your mask, but it's a lot more concentrated and effective. So do not compare a product 1:1, a product made with extract, and compare it that this is equivalent to using a mask on your hair. So here I'm just going to quickly have her hair, because we want it to be concentrate and ensure that the heat seals in her cuticle. Just have use a reusable shower cap and then have it sealed in. So that's it, guys. Thank you, mom.
Thank you, guys. Bye.
So we have shown 2 hair masks. The first one, just for repetition in case people missed out, the first hair mask was your banana, castor oil and tea tree oil hair mask for shiny hair, especially good for frizz. And those who have oily hair can use this mask. Use 5 drops of tea tree essential oil. The second mask what I showed you was coconut milk mask. The coconut milk mask is a lot more liquidy in nature, and this is used for people who have dry hair and or curly hair. And also we added rosemary essential oil in this. Again, 5 rosemary essential oil drops was added to ensure that it is good for controlling hair fall and promoting new hair growth. All the products which I mentioned during the video is available on our website vedat.com. Check out, because we do give out goodies along with purchases with products directly which I purchased from our website. So do check out Vedarth website. Anti hair fall hair oil for hair fall. Quickly summarizing some of the tips I mentioned. You can apply lavender water or rose water to your scalp or spray it onto your hair to quickly style and get your hair to lay flat. And because it's naturally water based, it will stay in place. Then we use sulfate free shampoos, and especially shampoos which are free of parabens, silicones and sulfates. Sulfate is very high in detergent, so it will dry your hair and increase the frizziness. Please switch to sulfate free shampoos and silicone free products. Check out the three hair shampoos at Veda Earth for dry, oily or dandruff prone hair. And also I did mention about the essential oils. So you have rosemary essential oil for hair growth. If you're looking for hair fall, controlling hair fall and hair growth, tea tree essential oil if you have itchy scalp and dandruff. And of course we do have other essential oils which can be used as well. So you have geranium essential oil if you're looking at increasing circulation in any hair oil that you use. You can add those. You can also add lavender essential oil, will give you good night's sleep. And any hair oil, when you apply, you need to massage your hair very well. Some of the tips that I mentioned was ensure that, you know, you do this movement, but you do not move your fingers actually, you move your scalp. This will ensure that the circulation in your scalp increases. This is one of the tips that I told you while using for head massage. This is good for both guys and girls. All of, men or women, you can use all of these tips. All these products can be used by anyone. Also look at pulling your hair or tugging your hair very lightly to ensure this tugging movement will also ensure that the weaker hair falls off and promotes good hair growth. So I'm also going to cover some of the questions some of you have been asking quickly. Spurti has asked, can I use any oil in place of castor oil? Yes, Spurti, you can look at using any of the oil here. I used castor oil in the mask because it's good for people who have oily scalp or dandruff. If you have dry hair, you can substitute it with coconut oil, or you can use oils like olive oil as well. It is interchangeable, or better yet, just apply your regular hair oil. Ensure whenever you use a hair oil, use oils which are free of mineral oil. Mineral oil is a petroleum based product which acts as a coating on your hair but does not add any nutrients to your hair itself. So it's not good for your hair in the long run. Instead, use natural seed based oils. If you observe the Vedarth hair oil, we have used sesame, almond and olive oil as a base. So each oil has its own benefit, and because it's three base oils used and multiple essential oils used in it, it's good for your hair and it's ready to use. So you can always have a hair oil applied to your scalp. I would recommend use it every day if you're looking for, you know, quick hair growth. Apply hair oil every day to your scalp and massage it well. If not, minimum once a week or twice a week, especially when your hair fall is lot more. Use it minimum once a week, leave it on for 2 hours and then wash off your hair. So that is there. We also have Deeksha who has added in a question, how long do I leave the hair pack or mask? These hair pack or mask what we have used is for the hair and not necessarily for the scalp. For scalp, oils work much better. There are hair packs meant for scalp treatment. Some of these are available at our Veda Earth lounge. You can check them out if you are in Bangalore. It's really good there. Guys, I have covered all the points on how to maintain good hair health and frizzy hair. Thank you for watching. Keep following Veda to know more natural tips on aromatherapy and how to follow a lifestyle meant to enrich self-care and promote self-care. Bye. Have a nice day.